After a 2-10 season last year, Kalispell's goal has been to raise the bar. But we sit here in week 4 and the Warhawks have yet to win a game this season. They've had chances to win 2 games so far but have not come out victorious, and now there are some concerns about the job security of head coach Leon Daniels, who is now a 2-13 head coach. Today the Warhawks play their final non-conference game. They're at home here in rainy Kalispell, Montana, as they take on the Tulane Green Wave. Next week, the Warhawks will begin Mountain West Conference play. Can they close out their non-conference schedule with a win and build some momentum? It's time to get underway. Kalispell football is back here in week 4, and we are off. Back deep is Sonny Archer, and here he comes from the 1. Between the hash marks, trying to spin outside, and taken down around the 25. So despite some throwing struggles last week, Marquise Walker is back to make another start today. As the Warhawks begin, twin tight ends, Walker rolling out right, not much room, and his first pass is intercepted! Taken away by Davis! And in what is a very important game for Kalispell, they turn it over on the very first play. I'm not sure Whitfield really saw this football, he didn't really react to it. Tulane takes over, they're already near the red zone, and this is a keeper on 1st and 10. But a nice tackle made by TJ Garner on Darius Bradwell limits Tulane to a gain of 1. Bringing Hilliard in motion, a play fake. Bradwell wants the run on 3rd down. He picks up the 1st and slides down around the 11. This defense had a lot of trouble last week against the running quarterback. We'll see if they've made any improvements. And here is Sherman Beatty bulldozing TJ Garner on his way to a Tulane touchdown. This offense runs through Sherman Beatty, and Sherman Beatty runs through safeties. 7-0 Green Wave. Going back to the Kalispell offense as they run the ball, this time on 1st down, but not much room there for Sammy Hawthorne. Now Walker in the shotgun, it's a 3-wide set, 3rd and 9. On target here, passing down the field to Donnie Castillo. And that is good for about 12 yards. We'll see how Walker's accuracy holds up here in the elements. And on 1st down, going back to some option now, and Walker is wrapped up quickly. They cover up Hawthorne, they take care of Walker, that's perfect option defense. Archer slot right, here's a pass from Walker. Outside here, Donnie Castillo working back to the inside for about 5 yards, setting up a 3rd and 6. Tyler Adams isolated left, Tulane rushes 4, Walker going down! This drive is ended by Quinlan Carroll. And again, Kalispell is out to a terrible start. 7-0 Tulane, they're back on offense, offset eye. Giving this to Sherman Beatty, off tackle, and falling forward across the 40. That is good for about 8. Kalispell needs to key in on that running game, and they appear to be trying that here, as Beatty fighting across the 50, and finally taken down by Marcus Calhoun. But that's how tough of a runner he is. After a gain of 9. Inside handoff, this is Hilliard, hurtling his way, 1st down and more in the secondary. Dontrell Hilliard rips off a run of 20 yards. Tulane now comes out in the flex bone. I'm not sure Kalispell has really seen much of this as Beatty cannot get outside. That is a good run fill there by Dorian Jordan. Now back to the shotgun as they spread the defense out. Bradwell floating outside and overthrowing his target. That was just his first pass attempt of the day. Same look on 3rd and 11. Bradwell, he is off balance and throws incomplete. Kalispell's defense able to hold, but Tulane can extend their lead further. 10-0 Green Wave. Walker out there again with the Kalispell offense as he throws it behind Sammy Hawthorne, looking for a quick little check down. Hawthorne to Walker's right, and now a blitz from the secondary. Walker off the mark, and lucky that wasn't picked, as that was in the direction of Donnie Castillo, but not exactly near him. 3rd down. Now a 3-man rush. Walker shot downfield, knocked away. Denying Donnie Castillo was Donnie Lewis Jr., and Tulane comes through again. It's been all Green Wave thus far. 1st down, here's Bradwell. Big blitz, off balance, and intercepted! And Tone Slater takes it away! And Kalispell's defense records their first interception of the season. This time the blitz pays off. They get Bradwell off balance. He throws a very ill-advised pass, and the defense capitalizes. And immediately out with the offense now is Austin Bradley. A change is made by Kalispell as the give goes to Sammy Hawthorne for a gain of 5. We've already seen Walker's accuracy issues arise in this game. Back they go to Sammy Hawthorne. Nice run here on second down as he picks up 7. This Tulane run defense has been a major weakness in their first two games. Here's the first pass from Bradley. That'll have to wait, actually. Down he goes, a loss of 4. Brain on Edwards. First quarter winding down, Bradley on second and long. That's off the hands and nearly intercepted. The rain is a big problem right now, and Kalispell needs to adapt to the weather. Third and 14, Bradley steps up, off balance. He caught that, first down, Tyler Adams. Just a desperation throw, basically, and a phenomenal catch. The drive continues for Kalispell, 2 tight ends and Bradley to pass. Taking a shot for Castillo, it's tipped, and a touchdown! Donnie Castillo off the deflection, gets the Warhawk offense on the board. 3 deflections by Tulane. What a break for the Warhawks as the weather finally helps them out in this game. 10-7 as the Green Wave take over. Here's Beatty, and he is swarmed by James Watson and Marcus Calhoun. Second quarter now underway. Kalispell showing blitz, and down goes Sherman Beatty. That is James Watson, the true freshman, making one of his biggest impact plays so far. That's a 3-and-out. Okay, after a touchdown drive by Kalispell, they are going back to Marquise Walker, and they go option. Walker has room and blocks. Following the path provided by his wideouts, Marquise Walker runs for 21. One thing we can't lose sight of in this game is that the conditions are not good for a full-on passing day. Walker keeping again. Gets some help from Adams. First down. Out of bounds near the 20. You know Kalispell wants to run in this game. Tulane has not stopped the run well so far this season. Now a play fake from Walker. And another chance to tuck it. First down inside the 10. Just 3 runs here by Walker, letting him play to his strengths. Goal to go, Kalispell. Now they go back to the air. Quick pass. Touchdown, Sonny Archer. And the Warhawks have taken the lead. This all turned on Antone Slater's interception. Touchdown drives by Marquise Walker and Austin Bradley have the Warhawks finally looking up here in week 4. Going back to the defensive side now, a trips look here for Bradwell as he's racked up quickly. Taken down by Brock Schultz. Everything going Kalispell's way right now. Second and 14. Towns breaks through, but open outside. This is Enkelade breaking a tackle of Slater and picking up the first down, trying to silence and flip this momentum. A stack box on second down, a blitz is sent. Bradwell, wide open, Enkelade. Taken down by Cam Davenport, but 15 more. Into long distance field goal range. Inside handoff, and Beatty goes down. That's Marcus Calhoun. These are the games where Calhoun needs to be at his best. He has to be the impact defender against these strong rushing games. Second down and 10, now it's Hilliard, and he breaks a tackle but is taken down by Garner, and that makes it a 3rd and 4. Can Kalispell get another stop? They're showing blitz and here they come, and a quick throw out of bounds as pressure was getting there very quickly, and they do force another field goal. Kalispell still up by 1 point as Walker is back out there at quarterback. He gives this to Hawthorne. Look at the blocks in front. Hawthorne trying to find a lane and taken down after a strong run into the secondary. Walker in the shotgun. A sweep here. Hawthorne following his lead blockers. That is a first down gain of 11 yards. Now they're finding rushing success, and that's why you see Walker back in the game. It opens up their running offense as Albert Green gets the shotgun counter and picks up 6 yards. Less than 3 minutes to go in this second quarter. A sweep now as Green is taken down quickly. Tulane reading that one. It's now 3rd and 7. Can Walker come through on these key situations? 3rd and 7. Walker again flush, solid coverage. And nowhere to go with it. That is ruled an incomplete pass. And it's 4th down, Warhawks. Back to Tulane. 2 minutes to go in the half as the give goes to Beatty. And he'll pick up the 1st down on this play. I think we're seeing both teams start to lean a lot more on their ground games. Tulane did that more from the beginning. Now it's Bradwell off the mark, and I'm not sure the receiver saw it. Could have had a chance to reel that one in. It's 3rd down. Corners on the outside playing off. A screen here. Bradwell to Beatty. Running out of room and taken down by Antone Slater. The redshirt freshman making a nice impact. 1 minute to go in the half, and they're going back to Austin Bradley now on offense as he's chased and connects with Troy Evans. Somehow he hangs on to this for 16 yards and gets back up. Evans also staying in the game. 1st down, Bradley again chased outside the numbers. Off balance and off the hands. Right through the hands of Tyler Adams. 48 seconds on the clock. Whitfield now in the action. A blitz is sent. Bradley, trouble, backing up, and down he goes. It's a loss of 16 yards for Kalispell, and they now let the clock run down. This could be the last play of the half. Bradley again off his spot and taken down from behind as a defender got a piece of the ankle. And that will take us to the break. 14-13. Kalispell leads after another ugly start. 2nd half up next. Welcome back to Week 4 action, Kalispell and Tulane. From the beginning, it was a very familiar start. Kalispell not playing well in the first quarter, but then finding their rhythm and they're now leading. But Bradwell on the Green Wave offense trying to change that as he gets plenty of room here on the option and gains 18. Trips right for Tulane as Bradwell steps up, lost the football, and it's recovered by Marcus Calhoun. Warhawks turn over Tulane for the 2nd time. Dorian Jordan knocks it out, and Calhoun is just able to win the race to the football. Coach Daniels has to love seeing his defense finally playing the way we hoped they would. And Walker is the quarterback to start this 2nd half as he rolls and now decides to throw it away. He's now 3 of 10 passing. It hasn't been a very effective passing day for him. But a 3rd and 6. Check down Sammy Hawthorne. That is enough to get the job done. But when they want to focus on the pass, we've seen them go to Bradley in this game. The backs are Benson and Green as Benson gets a carry, but not enough daylight as he only gains about 3 yards. I do want to see what Eddie can do this year after another offseason. Walker off the fake, rolling left, open. Here's Archer turning upfield and picking up 1st down yardage. I'm still very impressed with what we've seen from Sonny Archer. Trips left, and a give to Green. And the hole closes quickly as he picks up around 5, now 3rd down. The tight end is Donnie Castillo, 2 receivers right. Walker with time, lobbing, he has a man open, and it's ruled out of bounds. Tyler Adams almost has the touchdown. Take a second look, he does not get a foot in bounds. Kalispell tacks on a field goal, so their lead increases to 4. Bradwell rolling right, and he is leveled by Otis Frazier, continuing to be a physical presence. I feel like he's found his identity as a safety. 3rd down, and Bradwell quickly gets rid of this one again. Kalispell sent another blitz, and they get another punt. Quarterback again is Marquise Walker as they go to the running game. Well blocked here for Hawthorne to pick up around 5. Kalispell 3 of 8 on 3rd down. Archer in the slot. Walker in trouble, trying to dodge back to the right, and down he goes. Again, the pressure getting there. This time it's Sean Wilson. The scoring has definitely slowed down in this one as from the flex spot. This is Beatty going nowhere. This time it's Jeremiah Grant. They've done a much better job at slowing down this running game as the screen goes out to Encalade, who's been a very efficient player for Tulane today, getting another solid pickup. This one 24 yards. Nearing Kalispell territory on the ground, Sherman Beatty taken down by James Watson after a 3-yard pickup. Definitely liking what I'm seeing from Watson in this game. On second down, Hilliard gets a lane, first down, taken down by TJ Garner. They have a nice two-headed rushing attack with Hilliard and Beatty. Hilliard in motion, now it's Ford, the fullback trucking ahead. This time a 12-yard pickup. Tulane embracing this ground game now. 42 seconds to go in the third quarter. Bradwell going outside with this one to Andrew Hicks as the Green Wave pick up four. We're nearing the final quarter. Third and two. Here's option. The flip to Beatty. First down. And he runs back to the inside. If he goes outside, that's six. It's still first and goal, Green Wave. Now in the wishbone, it's Hilliard running into the end zone for a Tulane score. And the Green Wave are back on top here in week four. Very good possession, their best in a long time, 20-17. We'll see if the Warhawks have an answer as this kick goes deep to Sonny Archer inside the five. Looking to take this outside, look at that lane. Across the 35, Archer shoved out. Another nice return for Sonny Archer. Again, it's Marquise Walker. He started off every drive here in the third quarter. The give going to Sammy Hawthorne is good for four, and that will take us to the fourth quarter. It's another tight game for Kalispell. They've stayed in two games already this season, but they've yet to figure out how to get the win. Can they achieve that today? Hawthorne motions out on third and six. And Walker escapes the pocket in time. First down, Marquise Walker. They've just let him run in this game. When there's an opening, go and take it. Now Archer in motion, trying the triple option. And Walker goes down. They still cannot get that triple option working. Kalispell now facing a really tough third and 15. Walker is going to have to find a way here as he rolls outside the pocket. Only one receiver on this side. Last second lob, intercepted by Nickerson. Walker could not float it far enough, and Tulane takes over. We're going to need more plays from the defense here. Down three, give to Beatty, trying to break it out to the right side, and he's dragged down by James Watson. 71 rushing yards for Beatty. Now play fake for Bradwell, and wide open is Glenn, racing past Dante Clark. And down to the Kalispell 20. That was a 34-yard play. Inside to Ford now, getting room inside the five and taken down. Tulane on the verge of making this a two-score game in the fourth quarter. Can Kalispell hold? Bradwell option, laying out Davenport that clears the path. Touchdown, Dontrell Hilliard. Davenport was the last line of defense, and a tight end just took him out of the play. For the first time in the second half, Kalispell goes back to Austin Bradley as he fires a strike to Donnie Castillo. That's good for 11 yards. But now Kalispell much more focused on passing the ball and moving quickly. Makes sense that Bradley's back in. Off his spot, rolling to Castillo. Into Tulane territory, gains of 11 and now 20. 77 on the day for Donnie. On first and 10, Bradley again rolling out, has a man open, and connects with Evans. Inside the 20 and taken down inside the 15. Kalispell not wasting any time. This is how these drives are supposed to work. Inside handoff, and Sammy Hawthorne is denied after a short pickup. So a big third down for Kalispell. Don't want to get too aggressive, but want to try getting the touchdown here. Bradley knocked down, looking for Kendall Caldwell. But that will allow for a field goal try to make it a one-score game. Keith Britton on to kick, and the kick is good, 27-20. It's up to Kalispell's defense now. They stack the box, anticipating run. Hilliard taken down after a gain of five. He's been very efficient with his touches. Now back to the flex bone. Here's Ford, and he's going nowhere. James Watson having his most impressive game by far. Nine tackles for Watson. It's third and six. Bradwell looks to scramble, and he runs out of room, taken down by Zach Flowers. Kalispell's defense does force the punt. 2.5 minutes left to go. Crunch time in Kalispell. From the 34, this is Troy Evans looking to weave out and make a lane. He picks up 12. And here comes the Kalispell offense. Austin Bradley just led a solid field goal drive. Now they need a touchdown. A sweep. Nice job by Medlock. Across the 50. Patient running by Hawthorne rewards him with 9 yards. Archer slot right. Here's Bradley as he backs up, throws it short. There's Sammy Hawthorne. First down. Getting inside the Tulane 40. 2 minutes, 11 seconds remain. Now some option. Bradley keeping and taking all the contact. Gain of 6. Inside 2 minutes as the Warhawks go hurry up. Blitz. Bradley rolling again. Open. Sammy off his hands. He dropped another easy one. Could have been a potential conversion. Third down. Castillo the tight end. The back is green. Swing right. There's Albert Green. But the green wave closed quickly. Good open field tackle. And it's fourth down. To extend the Kalispell possession. It's Green, and he won't get there! Denied! The left side of Kalispell's line gets beat, and Green had no chance on the play. Now the defense has no room for error. Beatty taken down by Lewis Towns. That was close to a potential game breaker. Now running in motion. Give to Ford. Taken down here by Zach Flowers. It's 3rd and 6. A stop here will give the offense another shot. Kalispell's adjusted their play as Tulane goes trips right. It's a screen, and Glenn has running room. First down. There was a defender who ran right into another defender who was blocked, and Tulane gets the easy conversion. And that's going to send Kalispell to 0-4. Another heartbreaking loss in Kalispell. They stay in the game for the third time in 4 weeks. Yet they cannot come out in front. Kalispell falls 27-20. It's so frustrating to see a team have a chance to get these wins. They just can't figure it out late in the fourth quarter. It was another ugly start, but Kalispell ended up playing a pretty good football game. Maybe their best on the season. Austin Bradley came in. He played his role. Marquise Walker still played and stayed in his role. I like the way we used the quarterbacks in this game once the first quarter was over. We adapted well on both sides, that is, and our defense was much better against the run, and we were able to get some pressure and force some big plays. We just let Tulane get the best of us in the fourth quarter, and we end up losing again. Moving on now to recruiting. We do have our first commit of this recruiting class. It is North Dakota tackle Sean Gallagher. We were always a perfect fit for him. He wants to play early, stay close to Fargo. This is a great chance for him to play at the FBS level and get a chance to show what he can do. He's our first commit. Now we're increasing our lead for Ja'Cory Day. We still have the only offer for him, and he's going to visit in week 6. We're also still looking good in the recruiting battle for Roscoe Sheridan from Boulder, Colorado. We still have the only offer for him. Other teams are not offering these players scholarships, and these are the perfect players for us to target and prioritize. Shannon Evans, we have a nice lead for him. The top of our board looks extremely strong. I just hope it stays that way. Evans can be a complete safety. I think he has a very high ceiling. Then there's Dan Davis, the player I introduced to you guys last week, and we're already his first team on the board. We're the only team to offer to him. If teams want to overlook these talented players, I'm more than happy giving them a lot of interest. There's another player now we're putting more points into, middle linebacker Dante Johnson from Nebraska. And he is basically a pure run stopper. Big hitter, not very fast, not extremely athletic, but just a downhill run stopper. We have spots for players like him. If I haven't mentioned this already, I'm trying to make this a big recruiting class at the same time because we have a lot of juniors on the roster, only 9 seniors this year, so I'm hoping to get about 15 or more players in this class. We're looking good so far. Next episode, we open up conference play against San Jose State. And this is where the competition level is going to increase. That's why I'm so bummed we couldn't get any wins in our non-conference schedule, because these games were more evenly matched. We're now 0-4, still trying to find out how we can raise the bar here in year 2. What do you guys think this team needs to do if we're to start getting some wins? I do like the idea of rotating in the quarterbacks based on what we want to do with that possession. You saw Bradley play more when we had less time to work with and when passing was the emphasis, but Walker came in when it was time to run the football. I've also seen some say just take the red shirt off of J.R. Battle. I don't think that's the right move to make, because running the football is one of the things that we can do well, and it also reduces our risk of turning the football over, so I don't want to take the red shirt off J.R. Battle right now. But hopefully we can play well against San Jose State and sneak out a victory, because we need one badly. Thanks for watching, everybody. That's it for this episode. Hope you enjoyed. Be sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe for much more Kalispell Dynasty. I'll see you next time. Have a great day.